I can be seated.
Good afternoon. I am Linda Nairn. I'm chair of the naming committee of the San Antonio Public Library. Is this on? Okay.
Turn it on.
Okay. Okay. Again, good afternoon. I'm Linda Nairn. I am chair of the naming committee of the San Antonio Public Library Board of Trustees. Today's meeting is now called to order. Welcome, everybody. I'm so glad you came. Okay. Please call the roll. Jessica? Okay.
You have in attendance Linda Nairn, Jess B. Carr, Judy Cruz, Jean Brady, and Paul Stahl is absent.
Okay. I'd also like you to meet some of our people. We have Joanne Harris, who's our representative from District 2. Okay. We have Laura Eckler, who's not on the board, I don't think officially anymore, but has been for years and years. So yeah, she's here. And we have Ramiro Salazar, who is our library director. He's the big jefe. So glad to have him here. Okay. And this is Dale McNeil, who's one of the assistant directors. And we have Jessica. I don't remember your last name. It's gone away from me all of a sudden. Uridia. Okay. And she's the lady who runs everything. So she's the person. She's the jefecita. Okay. We're glad you're here to provide your thoughts about the proposed addition of the name Andres Sarabia to the name of the Las Palmas Branch Library. On August 28, 2019, the San Antonio Public Library Board of Trustees received a letter requesting consideration to add his name to the official name of the Las Palmas Branch Library. Today's input meeting is being live streamed also. The video recording of the meeting will be posted on the library's website, and that is mysapl, so it's mysapl.org. And you can, I guess it'll stay on there? Okay, so you can go home and watch it again if you want to. Okay. The purpose of today's meeting is for the Library Board's Naming Committee to receive public input from the community regarding this proposal. No action will be taken today. The committee will receive public comment only, and no deliberation will be conducted by the committee today. Okay. After today's public input meeting, the Naming Committee will consider at a later meeting the public input provided, conduct additional research as needed, and then make a recommendation to the Library Board of Trustees. The Library Board of Trustees will then make the final decision in a public meeting regarding this naming request. So this is just one step in the process. To say this again, at this point, no decisions have been made and no action will be taken today. However, hearing from you is an important part of this process. For your information, the Library Board of Trustees meets monthly, except in November, and the meeting agendas are posted in accordance with the Texas Open Meetings Act. Agendas are posted at all library locations, and they're also online on the city's website. Okay, next, our Library Director, Ramiro Salazar, will make welcoming remarks.
Good afternoon. Buenas tardes a todos ustedes. I do want to recognize we have Councilwoman Terry Castillo here with us. Welcome, Councilwoman. Thank you so much. And we also have representatives from Congressman Joaquin Castro. We have Alex Sarabia and Jasmine. Okay. So welcome, all of you. I believe there are no other officials that I need to recognize. Bueno, buenas tardes de nuevo. Solamente quería darles la bienvenida, saludarlos a todos ustedes. Si tenemos servicio para traducir, si acaso prefieren escuchar en español, aquí se pueden reportar con este joven aquí en mi izquierda, para esas personas que prefieren escucharlo, los comentarios y la junta en español. De nuevo, soy el director de la biblioteca, la red de biblioteca pública de la ciudad de San Antonio. Me da mucho gusto de que estén todos ustedes aquí. Es muy importante esta reunión, esta junta, porque queremos saber, queremos recibir comentarios de ustedes sobre la propuesta de incluir el nombre del señor Andrés Sarabia en la biblioteca. Y como reportó nuestra presidente, Linda Nairn, no se han hecho ninguna decisión en este momento. Ahorita solamente estamos obteniendo comentarios y opiniones. I'll say it in English very briefly. It's good for me to repeat what our chair of the naming committee reported. Again, the purpose of this meeting is to obtain public input, to get your feedback on the proposal. It's a proposal to add the name to Las Palmas. It's not to replace the name. I want to emphasize that. It's not to replace the name of the Las Palmas Library. It's to add the name. The naming committee of the Library Board of Trustees has the responsibility and the role of, once a request is submitted to the library, they're charged with getting public input, doing research, and making sure that the individual fits the credentials identified in the naming committee. The naming policy can be found. Do we get copies here? There's copies here, but it can also be found on the library's website. If you go to the link about, you can find the naming policy, and it describes the whole process there. But again, I just want to emphasize, we're going through a process. We want to be deliberate about this decision. The naming committee will make a recommendation to the full library board, where further deliberation will occur and a decision is made on the request, again, to consider the name of Andres Sarabia to be added to this library. I'm pleased that we have a nice turnout to get public feedback. I do want to emphasize that there's different ways of continuing to provide feedback. There's the library's website, there's a phone number, and I don't have it in front of me, Jessica. But we'll provide that. The number that they can call is
210-207-2595.
Okay. All right. Got it. Thank you. So I just wanted to emphasize that there's plenty of opportunities for those individuals that were not able to be here or were concerned because it's an in-person meeting. By the way, we have masks for those that forgot their mask and you're interested in wearing a mask. We have some in the back, but I can see that practically all of you are wearing masks. That's good from my perspective. And with that, again, welcome, and I'll turn it back to Dale McNeil. Let me introduce Dale. In fact, this will give me an opportunity to recognize not only Dale McNeil is our Assistant Director for Public Services, but also recognize Jessica Zurita, who's our Chief of Staff. She's the one that works behind the scenes and coordinate all the logistics and everything that's coming together, along with the library team, of course. And so I wanted to recognize Jessica, and at this time, Dale will explain the logistics of how the meeting will be conducted. And go ahead, Dale.
So once again, good afternoon, and we're really glad so many of you are here to provide your input. And we will actually get started soon. So, these parts I think are really important as well, so that we are able to hear from everyone. So following the general pattern of the City Council meetings, each speaker today will have up to 3 minutes to address the committee. If you're self-identified as a group, the group together will have 9 minutes, and then that will count as the time for all those members of the group. Library staff member will read the name of each speaker when it is their time to speak, and those will be the people who indicated yes, that they wanted to speak. on the sign-in. So if you want to change that, you can go and you can, you know, if you didn't quite understand, you needed to say yes, you wanted to speak, we'll happily accommodate you. Because we're in this time of pandemic, we'll wipe down the microphone after each speaker, so that'll take a minute or two. Just be aware that that's going to happen. We do have a timer because I think we all know it's hard to have an internal clock as exactly what is 3 minutes. So we do have a timer over here with an alarm, and really that's just for your convenience. It's really meant to make it flow more easily. So there is a not too obnoxious alarm that will sound when 3 minutes have concluded. There are many individuals signed up to speak today, so please do keep your comments within the 3 or 9 minutes. Again, please note this is an opportunity for the naming committee of the Library Board of Trustees to receive your public comments. To ensure that each speaker has the full opportunity to speak, there will be no dialogue between the committee and speakers and no dialogue between speakers. So each one of you is just addressing the naming committee. As Ramiro mentioned, there are comments that we've received before the meeting. So what we will do today is, first, the committee will receive the in-person comments because you made the effort to be here. So we want to hear from you first. Then the written comments will be read following the same timeline. So even if the person wrote a very long letter, it will follow the same 3-minute timeline, and then we'll play any voice messages. If you would like to provide public comment and you have not already signed up, please take this opportunity to sign up at the front of the meeting room just as you were when you were coming in. So we will now, I believe, begin, and Jessica will be calling individuals one at a time by the order that people signed in this morning. Thank you again.
Sister Pearl Sessok, followed by Sister Gabriella.
Good afternoon. My name is Sister Pearl Caesar. I am the Superior General of the Congregation of Divine Providence. Our offices are at 515 Southwest 24th Street. We sponsor Our Lady of the Lake University, Providence Catholic School, and we minister throughout the United States and Mexico. This is the library we use, and this is where we come to vote. Our congregation gives full support to renaming this library the Andres Sarabia Las Palmas Library. Andy served as the first president of COPS, Communities Organized for Public Service. In that role, he set the foundation for COPS achievement since 1974. Andy saw the inequities perpetuated in San Antonio's inner city neighborhoods, home to Mexican Americans. COPS and Andy set about doing its work. Since then, the COPS organization, just to name a little of its achievements, has directed over $2 billion worth of infrastructure improvements to the South and West Side, passed bond issues and increased city budget to ensure infrastructure, initiated new housing and the demolition of substandard housing, passed bonds for neighborhood libraries and leadership and learning centers. We would not be having this meeting here today if it were not for Andy and COPS. They also created the San Antonio Housing Trust, the San Antonio Education Partnership, Alliance Schools, After School Programs, and Project Quest. Initiated action for building Palo Alto Community College, worked for the approval of single district city council districts, and recently worked to pass SA Ready to Work. Among the organization's most significant achievements have been leadership development of ordinary citizens, just like Andy, voter education and registration drives, and get out the vote campaigns. Andy saw the grave discrepancies in our city. He did not work for personal gain. Instead, he acted on behalf of the community, and changes that came about benefited the whole community, and they are here to stay for future generations. The renaming of this library is a small token of appreciation and recognition to a man who devoted his adult life for the good of the community, and it will set an example and a model to the rest of the community of what needs to continue in our city. Thank you very much for your time.
Sister Gabriela, followed by Beatrice Cortez.
Good afternoon. I'm Sister Gabriela, Holy Spirit sister from the east side of San Antonio. But this neighborhood is very important to me. I went to school over at Our Lady of the Lake. To members of the Board of Trustees, the naming committee, and to Mr. Salazar, good evening. I am here to state why I believe, and my congregation believes, this library should honor a very constructive and long-to-be-remembered member of our community, Mr. Andres Sarabia. Andy gave 45 years of his life totally engaged with COPS because he knew the value of the organization for San Antonio and following the model of COPS and the improvement it did in San Antonio, COPS was replicated in Arizona, New Mexico, California, and several other states in the United Kingdom. And of course, there are COPS organizations all over the state of Texas in all the big cities. Andy Sarabia was the heart of COPS, starting in 1974, and after the merger of COPS and Metro Alliance in 1988, until he died at 79 years in 2019. I cannot enumerate or describe all Andy accomplished, not alone. He did not do it alone. He had those whom he inspired and mentored to accompany him in this great work. Altogether, COPS and Metro leveraged over $2 billion in funding for the city of San Antonio. Here are some of the initiatives, and I don't want to repeat Sister Pearl, but they take repeating. Infrastructure, streets, and drainage. The children were walking to school in the water, and they cleared that up. And COPS. Alliance schools where teachers and parents worked together to improve our schools and thereby improve instruction. COPS brought in educators to work with our parents at COPS' expense. COPS and education partnership for high school students, where high school students who had 85% average attendance and maintained a B average in academics, got a partial scholarship to a four-year university when they graduated. Andy was for education and the common good. Andy pushed for libraries. Mexicans can't read, he was told. Well, they can, Andy said. Get them the books. Bring in a library. Libraries were built with bond money. 7 of them, 11 were built 1 year, and one cycle. And Las Palmas was one of them. 7 were built in the COPS neighborhoods. Is that my time? Give me a second. He facilitated founding of Palo Alto and got a doctorate, received a doctorate from Palo Alto for the work he did. He was told they wouldn't go to college, too, the Mexicans wouldn't, but you know what they did when they got to college. The diabetic hospital, let's not forget it. Project Quest, a jobs training initiative that pays adequate wages and benefits. Project Quest is now very well known all over the country and is very highly regarded. Now, who's next? You know, I'll tell you a fast story, real quick. You know what the kid said from the back of the church when the priest said, "Where did I stop?" He said, "You're close to the end." I am here to state why I said that. Oh, excuse me, my God. Please forgive me, Cops Metro. The greatest contribution was made in the development of Cops Metro leaders. Power is a misunderstood word. Power is the ability to act. Andy taught us that. He taught us about right relationships. Justice is a right relationship. Justice exists when relationships are right. Everyone is equal and right. I'm through. Everyone is equal and all have a right to education, healthcare, and nutrition. Thank you very much, everybody. I appreciate you, and I appreciate your patience.
Beatrice Cortez, followed by Orlinda Sarabia.
My name is Beatrice Cortez. I was the fourth president of the COPS organization, 81 and 82. I joined COPS because the San Antonio School District Board was closing my children's elementary school, Ben Milam. I stayed because of leaders like Andres Sarabia, who challenged me to do more, to make dreams come true for people in underserved communities. And we started dreaming. All we had to do was go to a meeting at one of our churches and say, "What do you think we could do in this neighborhood?" And the answers kept coming. "We can do better schools. We can put air conditioning in our schools. We can do sidewalks. We can do drainage. We can do housing. We can do something about better wages." Everybody's dream became a topic of conversation and a way to bring people together. We started even dreaming about parks. We started dreaming about tax abatements. When seniors would come in and they'd say, "This is the house that my husband left me or my son left me. And now I'm losing it because the taxes are too high and I don't know how to handle it. They want me to fix it because the neighbors are saying that my house is dilapidated, but I don't have the money." So we begin to look at answers, and that was the challenge that Andy Sarabia gave to me and to many leaders. Dream and then think, focus on a strategy of how to make it happen. I am here today to say that it is a small token, a very small token, for a library to be named after a man like Andres Sarabia. None of us, none of the leadership, got paid one red cent for the work that we did. And we worked weekends. We gave up time with our children, with our families, get-togethers. But it was a price, a sacrifice that we were willing to make because the communities were important. And we look back now on our neighborhoods as I was driving over here, and you see all these streets and curbs and sidewalks, parks, schools. I saw J.T. Brackenridge coming through on Guadalupe. Work that we did that Andy Sarabia was part of. He deserves that honor of having the school renamed. Thank you very much.
Orlinda Sarabia, followed by Ninfa Cantu.
Good morning, and thank you so much for having us here today, Mr. Salazar and board members. I am Orlinda Ledesma Sarabia. I am the wife of Andres Delgado Sarabia. I am here with family and friends, as well as COP members. All of us here from different sections of town. All of us became a family. Andy requested two things at the last days of his life. as we were at University Hospital for 17 days. One was to vote in the election that was pending, and the second one was to have his name added, and I emphasize added, to the Las Palmas Library, next to his friend and brother in justice, Albert Benavides. He voted with the help of his grandnephew, Alex Sarabia. Thank you, Alex. And here we are today to request the second part of his request. Las Palmas was built in 1955. It housed our favorite store, Josky's, and was the core of this neighborhood. And he knew this when he turned to me and asked, I want my name added to Las Palmas. He said to me as well, do not delete Las Palmas, it's the neighborhood. He grew up in this neighborhood, worked in this neighborhood, fought many battles for social justice in this neighborhood through the organization of COPS, now known as COP Metro. Andy grew up at 3225 Colima Street. That house still stands today. Six children in a small house, hot in the summer, cold in the winter, and when it rained, children played in its flooded streets. It was their swimming pool. They call it Colima River. And here are two of his siblings right here, Beatriz Torres and Olympia Jimenez. Those are his two siblings, and one is in Dallas. In 1974, Andy, grown, married, and living in Loma Park, stood in his yard in 2 feet of water when Ernesto Cortez, the director of IAF, Industrial Areas Foundation, said and agitated him, says, do you like standing in water every time it rains? Andy grew quietly agitated, angry, when he remembered his early childhoods on Colima Street. And so was born COPS Metro. And Andres Sarabia found himself in the center of it all, became the face of a people power organization known as COPS. But Andy went about it quietly. Meetings started in parish halls, bringing people together, equally as angry with social injustices. They banded together into a disciplined force, power in numbers. People learned their power was in voting. They demanded structural change, a place at the table. And so the Mayberry drainage became a reality and there was no more flooding. In 74, the bond issue came, presented to Andy Sarabia by someone here, and they reviewed, he turned, sent it to the COPS membership. They saw the value in their communities and 11 libraries were designated in the COPS area as indicated here. The example is, the libraries throughout our city, as Andy said, for all children to dream, an outlet for natural creativity and further their curiosity. These libraries are used by people of all statures, students, researchers, people that need technology, job seekers, parents, daily. You provide the library, and I'll say you, provide economical growth. People are able to read for a literate public, social mobility, and the big plus, the libraries are free. They allow a child or a young person to dream the dream so that the dreams can become realities and they can function here, to read the history and make history. Andy Sarabia worked diligently on behalf of the injustices of the poor neighborhoods. His ideas and actions to educate and empower people was for all parts of San Antonio, not just the west side, east side, north, and south side. I'll just finish, ma'am, with this, that I respectfully ask that when you walk out today, look across the street and look at the mausoleum of our Divine Mercy, and there you rest Andy Sarabia in peace, looking back this way at his neighborhood, looking across the street at Las Palmas, and he still is resting there. He's still in the neighborhood.
Ninfa Cantu, followed by John Ocoset.
Ladies and gentlemen, We are trying to limit you to 3 minutes. And when the little thing dings, I want you to finish your sentence and just, that's it, okay? I hate to try and keep stopping people, but y'all don't seem to understand that we're trying to give it time for everybody to talk. Okay.
Can I start now?
We're going to be reading your letter to everybody.
Okay. My name is Nympha Cantu. I am a leader of CAPS Metro Sacred Heart. And I would like to say that it was a great privilege and honor to know Mr. Sarabia. He taught me not, you know, there's a saying in CAPS, don't do for others what you can do for yourself. He taught me that I should go out and find and work. In our church, we closed 3 bars. They were making problems for our children and our families. I worked or volunteered at Basan Library, one of the libraries that Mr. Sarabia helped build. Why? Because we needed to educate people, but we also needed to educate the public in getting their citizenship. We had a class there, but it's not there anymore, and that's where libraries come in. Libraries help people, they educate people. A child learns. When you see a child get a book, his eyes open up, and he says, this is what Mr. Sarabia wanted. He wanted people, our children and adults, to educate. We have the summer program, as you all know, in the libraries for children to know. We have a literacy problem in our neighborhoods where children need to learn and read. And that's what Mr. Sarabia wanted. He wanted for children to go to the libraries and learn and read. And it's a whole different world when you're at a library, because I saw it when I was volunteering there. Children, adults, they would come and they would be in awe at the things they could learn, the computers, because many children and many adults don't have computers in their houses. So they go to the libraries. It's very important. And I would ask all of you to please give the honor to Mr. Sarabia of putting his name along with Las Palmas Library. Thank you.
John Althusser, followed by Steve Delamontes. I'm not sure if you'd like to.
No, okay.
John Torres.
Good afternoon. My name is John Alcosas, a leader with St. Patrick's COPS. When I first started with the organization, I was 18 years old, a young person that was afraid of what to do for his future. Mr. Sarabe took me under his wings and taught me that fear was going to hold me back. He said, take on the challenge that one of our schools was closed down, that we had bridges that needed to be rebuilt, that we had drainage problems in our communities. And so I took on that challenge. Over the many years, my jobs have focused on tackling the jobs of working with parents. Currently, I am a family and community engagement specialist with SAISD. SAISD has a family and community engagement specialist in every school. We deal with parents. Right now, the big issue is COVID, but we're keeping the parents calm that's something that we can succeed and win. Andres Sarabia instilled in me that we were going to succeed in anything that we took on the challenge. The school that I work with right now is Dory Miller. With Dory Miller, the children are proud of the fact that we had an individual that was a leader at the time that America was being attacked during World War II. He took on the machine gun and he shot down the Japanese planes. Well, Andres Sarabia didn't do that. What Andres Sarabia did was he brought in buses of people to take on the leadership of our city. The leadership of our city who would rather look at the north to build in the north direction. We needed our problems solved here on the west side, on the east side, on the south side. And that's why I'm here right now, proud of the fact that Andres Sarabia instilled in me that we can. I want our community to say we have our Dory Miller here on the west side. We're going to remember Andres Sarabia. His ammunition were the buses loads of people that came to the meetings. His ammunition and his guns were the people, and we took on Lila Cockrell, we took on Henry Cisneros, we took on Charles Becker, and we told them, it's our tax dollars. We demand it. We demand that these dollars come to our communities because we pay our tax dollars like everybody else. Thank you very much. Don't forget, Andres Sarabia Library.
John M. Torres, followed by Miguel Baldillo.
Hello, my name is John M. Torres. I'm Andres Sarabia's brother-in-law. It says a building dedication often begins with a memory of, dedicated to, or to honor and recognize the dedication of. I first met Andrew in the fall of 1981, a modest man and first president of the COPS, as it was rumored that I was going to marry his sister B. A man of passion for his community, organizing COPS Metro, a coalition of congregations, schools, and unions coming together so we can effectively act on behalf of families, children, neighborhoods, working with businesses, communities, and elected officials by making San Antonio a better place to live and work. My brother-in-law, Andrew Sarabia, although has passed on, still had this vision for San Antonio. What a better way to commemorate his legacy than by dedicating a portion of this library with his name, inspiring future generations with his love and vision for San Antonio. Thank you.
Miguel Baldillo, followed by Leticia Alcocet. Leticia Alcocet. Mike Reyes III. Father Mike DiGeroni.
Thank you for allowing this to happen. I'll be very brief in my comments. I assure you, no sermons today. Please allow me to say with all of my heart that I support all of the previous speakers who have said very eloquently what Mr. Andres Sarabia has done for these communities. Therefore, I support wholeheartedly, and I pray that this library will be renamed the Andres Sarabia Library at Las Palmas. Thank you.
Rachel Delgado, followed by Julia Soto.
Hello, my name is Rachel Delgado. I'm a lifelong resident of this neighborhood. And I'm wondering how you're going to make this long title of the name, because I think the Las Palmas part is very important. We had the shopping center. It was a big boost to the economy here on the west side. They built houses that are the Las Palmas subdivision. And then we finally got a library, which was the previous building. And that was wonderful, because before that, I would have had to take the bus to the Prospect Hill Library. So I guess that got replaced by Basan. Either that or go downtown. So it was a big part of the neighborhood. So I'm just wondering, how long of a title is this library going to have? I'm also a member of the Westside Preservation Alliance, so I'm always curious like what the history of the neighborhood is and all that. But I'm just anxious to see how this is going to work out with a name change, because I remember there was the big controversy with the old Highway 90. So thank you.
Andres Julia Soto, followed by Elise Dolan. B. Torres. Olympia Sarabia. Next on, Michael A. Sarabia. A. Sarabia. Followed by Leticia Sanchez.
Thank you. Buenas tardes, board members and family, friends. My name is Michael Sarabia, Michael Andrew Sarabia. I'm Andy Sarabia's son. And I just wanted to share a couple of minutes. I'm here today from Monterrey, Mexico. My brother here is here from Midlothian, just south of Dallas here. So we just came in to be a part of this. And thank you for your time and for your acknowledgement of this. Since the age of seven, I have probably been a library card holder. And I've greatly appreciated the value that the library has brought to the communities of San Antonio. I checked out my first books at a mobile library parked at the Loma Park Plaza on Culebra Road every Monday. Many times I carried these books well wrapped in towels and bags when I had to walk through the flooded streets of Culebra to return my books and check out new books. Funny, I still can remember the smell of those little trailers, you know? They had a funny smell. Rooms. I didn't want to go anymore because of that smell. My dad told me, you know, son, I was about 7 years old. He told me, you know, son, when you're going to go through life and you're going to smell a lot of poop worse than that in your life. Well, the real libraries are smelling a lot better now, or I've been through a lot of poop. But through my parents' encouragement to have my reading, my love for reading grew, and I really enjoyed collecting reading certificates during the summer. All was well worth the experiences of that continue today, as I still am a patron of the library. Today, thanks to the efforts of so many people and organizations, including my dad, Andres Andy Sarabia, libraries have so much more value, have gained so much more value to our communities and added so much more value. Friends, I stand here today only a five-minute walk from where my dad grew up on Colima Street and a few feet from where he was finally laid to rest across the street directly in front of here at the San Fernando Cemetery. And I'm joined by others to share reasons to why they should add my dad's name to this library, but I feel that my dad would rather have me speak more about the importance of this particular library has in his community. Wow, a lot has happened since May the 3rd of 2019 when he passed. But this library has continued to shine in this community. Even the time of shrinking municipal budgets combined with the craziness of this technological revolution, this library, along with the Learning Center, continue to focus on building a strong, educated community, united face-to-face, or should I say face-mask to face-mask. The staff continues to strive with all they can to inspire, educate about the arts, literature, and even music and leadership. More than just books and computers, this library is again a gathering place for the people of this community to explore, interact, and imagine. It's a birthplace to many dreams. Libraries today are community builders. Las Palmas Library is much more than an inclusive and diverse community center where barriers of diverse languages can be broken and ideas can become successful projects, and even for some, it's a university, and more importantly, it's a champion for the youth of this community. This library is here, this is more than just a building. It's a world of hope, knowledge, and wisdom, and the cultures, and the coraje that can be found in the thousands of books and in the hearts and minds of the people of this community that come to this library. And so I know my time is up, so I'll stop there. Thank you.
Leticia Sanchez, followed by Herinio Rodriguez.
Hi, my name is Leticia Sanchez, and I'm a resident of this community. I was born, raised, and currently live here. And I'm a very proud resident of this community. I'm here to state my opposition to the proposed renaming of the Las Palmas Library for the following reasons. Although Mr. Sarabia contributed to the development of the community, honoring him and specifically singling him out by adding only his name to the current Las Palmas name minimizes and practically erases the hard work put forth by a community of individuals, mostly women, who spent so much time and effort to make the Las Palmas Library a reality for our community. It would be a slap in the face to these women, to these individuals who baked and sold cakes to raise money, who spoke up publicly and made demands, all in an effort to bring the Las Palmas Library to our community. The name Las Palmas holds a special place for our community, and those of us who grew up in the community, and for those of us who grew up in the community. We've all witnessed so many changes in our barrio, some good, some bad, and some necessary. Unfortunately, a lot of the change taking place is erasing our history, and although some people may think a change in name or adding a name is not a true change in history, I state that it is. This isn't a necessary change, and we hope that the Board of Trustees will respect our community voices to keep the name of Las Palmas Library as Las Palmas. I think if we want to honor Mr. Sarabia, we need to think the public library on Soledad has no name. It's the San Antonio Public Library. We should honor him by renaming that, the Andres Sarabia Public Library. It would be more of a way to honor him in a more visual way. So we believe that there are many other ways in the community also and the library that can honor Mr. Sarabia and not only Mr. Sarabia, but the other community members who worked hard on the Las Palmas Library project within the library. We could commemorate a wing, or we could create a wall of recognition to include Mr. Sarabia's name and those of the other individuals. A wall with names and a history of the individuals would be more educational and would serve to honor all those who worked hard to bring the Las Palmas Library to our community. Thank you for your time.
Mr. Rodriguez, followed by Alex Sarabia.
Take off my mask or? Hello, my name is Eugenio Rodriguez, and I got to meet Mr. Sarabia many years ago. And what I learned is that he did do great things, many things. But there was something that really irked me. There was a clash in the way things were done. The way I was brought up is that the end does not justify the means. And the teachings that were done there was that the end did justify the means. And then what is just and right became a footnote. So when you, let's say you want something, it doesn't matter how you get to it as long as you get to it. That's not the way I was brought up. I was brought up that the end does not justify the means. In our case, it dealt with our voting rights. I myself was very ill at the time. I had trouble. I had to use a cane to walk. And I picked up about 1,200 signatures. Alongside me was another COPS person that the lady right here on Luby's, we were sitting there and all of a sudden she says, I don't feel well, so we had to call an ambulance. That was the passion we had so that we could all have the right to vote on an issue. Many others did the same. I approached Mr. Sarabia and I asked him, how are you doing with signatures? And he would just smile, he would just smile. What I was not aware of is that there was another end that was being sought. So here I am going home and getting fevers and stuff, getting signatures. And this culture was there. But I said, no, I'm seeing everything wrong. So I even went, which I had never done in my life, to the diocese. And I asked, is this proper? So they got me an advisor for the bishop, which is really like, wow. And he knew the catechism of the Catholic Church, the Vatican laws. He knew the pages, he knew the paragraphs. And I said, aren't we supposed to protect God's water? And he would just go, yep, go to page such and such, go to paragraph such and such. And he was smoking a cigarette, because he told me, let's go outside, I like to smoke, okay. So he's smoking a cigarette. So we were all sheep following blindly. Now, I hear all these accomplishments, but after seeing that our vote was put to the side for other issues, how many other things happened that we're not aware of? So if you can put on the bottom of it, the end justifies the means, so that that way we don't repeat that. Now, what happened is mob mentality, because everybody was afraid to speak. I myself spoke in one meeting surrounded by about 200 people. And I told them, this is not right. And somebody was standing speaking, and they said, no, but this is right. So I told them, move, and you will see what you all wrote about a week ago. It says there, and it did say, do what is just and right. So he was a wonderful man. He was very nice, I mean, very nice. But the modus operandi for getting things done was not in my nature. So if you could do that and make sure that people don't follow it, that the end does not justify the means, it would be good. Thank you.
Alex Sarabia, followed by Esmerald Alanis.
Good afternoon. Thank you to the naming committee and the library board for convening this public hearing today. I'm Alex Sarabia, the great nephew of Andres Sarabia. My great uncle had a few last wishes before he passed away 2 years ago. He was a man of faith, and so he wanted to have the holy sacraments and the last rites before he died. He also believed deeply in our democracy, and he wanted to vote in the last May municipal election. And so I helped him cast his final ballot. And lastly, he hoped that his name could be added to the Las Palmas Library, which he helped build through his work with as the first president and co-founder of COPS, Communities Organized for Public Services. And that's why we're here today, to honor the work of Andy Sarabia, who cared tremendously about this community, who worked tirelessly to empower his fellow neighbors to have a voice in their own government. I first learned about my great uncle's work as a young college student. I thought it was remarkable that someone in my own family had been so influential in the development of our city, in the advancement of our people, especially for Mexican-American families here on the west side of San Antonio. And as you all might know, COPS was founded in 1974, just a decade after the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act were passed, and just a year before the 1975 amendments, which covered Texas and language minorities, such as Spanish speakers, and ultimately led to San Antonio changing the single member districts, giving greater representation to folks. And Andy Sarabia and COPS were integral to the Mexican-American civil rights movement here in San Antonio. He helped organize this community, block by block, church by church, to help folks realize their rights and their power in our democracy and in our city. He rejected the inequality and the injustice that he saw around him, the streets that without sidewalks, the roads without drainage, the neighborhoods without libraries. And he understood that in a democracy, that the most powerful title we have is not that of president or of governor or of mayor, but it's citizen. And he cared deeply about giving the chance for his fellow neighbors to be able to influence their government and ultimately work for investments in their communities. And Las Palmas Library is a powerful example of that. For over 40 years in community service, Andy was a quiet soldier for social justice, working the levers of government to win significant for improvements for our community. And it's not often that the contributions of Latino leaders in U.S. history are recognized. And I hope that this committee and the library board will consider and recognize the work of Andy Sarabia. Thank you.
Esmerald Alanis, followed by Linda Arange.
Hello, my name is Emerald Alanis, and I am a citizen of the Las Palmas Library. So I grew up in this neighborhood. I've been here since I was a child, and I always came to get books or even a library card. I believe the name should not be changed, or added at least. I feel like in remembrance, he did so much for the COP areas, and I feel like that area should be respected. There should be maybe a board, like another person said. Sorry. But I do believe he did a lot for this community. Even though this is my first time hearing of him, I feel like many of the people here today are represented by the COPs. Even though their action in the community has helped many, they have not really been impactful in my generation. And I feel like if we knew more about him in this generation or in this life, I would have more respect for him or have known better that maybe we should have added it. But he was not the only one in the COPS organization, even though he was the first president. I feel like we should have still a remembrance for him, but not just the name renamed of it. Thank you.
Linda Arange, followed by Jose Angel Gallegos.
Good afternoon, and thank you for having this hearing for us. I'm Linda Arange, and I am currently serving as Vice President of the Friends of Las Palmas Library. Delia Trimble, who is our president, Delia Ramirez Trimble, grew up in this area. She and her brother are both on the board. And so we would like to welcome you, and we're so excited that you showed such great interest in the library. We've had two meetings, and they've been slightly different, but it's nice to know that everyone seems to have a lot of love and pride in having this library in our area. Whatever the decision is made, or whenever we make that decision, we're excited to welcome a lot of you and hope, because we have been serving since, well, I think it's about 10 years now as officers of the Friends. We have been seeking new members because we believe, although Delia and her brother Robert Ramirez both grew up in this area, we would like to see more interest come from the local community. And so I'm hoping that because there's been so much interest in renaming this library, that you all will also serve and agree to serve as Friends of the Las Palmas Library. I know that you all are all very busy doing other things, but you have, by showing up today, show that you have a love for the library, and we have a love for the library, but we're getting old. And so we would like a lot of the work that we do. It's like doing functions. We do Dia de los Muertos. We go out to Port Essay for different functions that they have for us. And it's kind of fun. I mean, it's also a lot of work. But I do want to remind you that the library runs only as well as the volunteers that can help us, because the kids need a lot of time, and sometimes this is where they get that special time. So if y'all can agree to come today for this renaming, I hope that you don't forget us, and we thank you for using the library, and we look forward to reopening so that we can all be together again. However, we are closing. When? Ramiro, we will be closing in a couple of weeks.
No, not in a couple of weeks.
A couple of months.
We're going to finish Memorial Branch Library. After that's finished, then we'll start the construction project here. So it'll probably be early 2022.
Well, then you have lots of time. Perhaps you can come do Dia de los Muertos with us if we're kind of open. And, you know, we always are doing crafts and things with the people. So while you're showing the love and desire to want to rename the library because you realize what an honor and a privilege it is to be part of this library. It would be really great if you all come help us. If you have a talent, if you know how to do papeleros, if you know how to make a piñata, we would love you to come by and have a class one day. So anyway, I know that this is not quite what this is about, but I did want to thank you all for showing interest in renaming the library. Thank you.
Jose Angel Gallegos, followed by Jeannie Gonzalez.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair, honorable members of the board, Mr. Salazar, thank you and welcome to our barrio. My name is Jose Angel Gallegos, Jr., a lifelong member and resident of District 5. I grew up not too far from here on Southwest 19. I've seen many, many changes, most of them positive for our district and our barrio. I remember walking through the field on my way to Western Auto that was next to our HEB, our neighborhood HEB store. Not only did I grow up in District 5, I went to school at Our Lady of the Lake University, and I've also worked the majority of my life in District 5. I currently have an organization, nonprofit, that is named Adelante, which translates to forward. And I'm encouraged by the forward progress that we're making in the consideration of adding the name of Andres Sarabia, a fellow social worker and colleague of mine, who I met when I was studying at Our Lady of the Lake University. I shared the vision of Andres for the betterment of our community and for setting examples for our young people, especially our children, in the name of education. But along with that challenge of educating not only our own, we had to educate others about the fact that we existed and that we had needs and that we also wanted to be self-sustaining, given an opportunity to succeed and to compete. I urge you to consider adding the name of Andres Sarabia. As director of Adelante, I strongly support, along with my education, with my organization and its board of directors, I strongly support your consideration. I leave you with a thought, esperanza, which means hope. And I believe that that is what Andres Sarabia's dream was all about. Gracias.
Jeannie Gonzalez, followed by Manuel Garza.
Good afternoon. My name is Jeannie Chapa Gonzalez. I'm in the neighborhood. I lived in this neighborhood for the past 63 years. I attended Sarah Kane Elementary, Rhodes Middle School, and Lanier High School. I realized that the name is wanted to be changed. However, this is deep roots of the Las Palmas Library. There's other, like someone indicated, it could be presented other names in other locations. I realize that he's from the COPS. However, COPS Metro has always been involved with it. I think if anything, maybe include just COPS Metro Las Palmas Library, because they've done a lot to our community. So that's all I needed to say. Thank you.
Manuel Garza, followed by Graciela Sanchez.
Good afternoon. My name is Manuel Garza. I'm a lifelong resident of District 5 and 6, because with single member districting, we've gotten changed several times. But still in the same neighborhood, still in Edgewood. I really like the fact that you're honoring my friend, Andres D Sarabia. I've known Andres for many years. My family lived right off the creek of Mulberry, the Mulberry, creek there. And that's what started the whole organizing of COPS. And so it's been a long, long, long struggle. And so it's always been a team effort from the get-go. From the walkout at Edgewood High School, which I was part of when I was a junior in high school, to the organizer of Southwest Voter Registration Project, which I'm still working with right now, and still registering people to vote and getting out the vote. But all of that is part of what we all did. Andres, Ernie Cortez, Willie Velasquez, I can go on and name a lot of names of people that were involved at that time. So it's an honor to have Andy's name being considered. But I think we should honor what Andy asked. Have my name added to the list. And because it was a big effort. It was a big, big effort, community effort. And so I have a lot of respect for everybody that was involved, all the organizing that we did, I remember when I got fired from my job. We're asking for single member districts. And so, but that didn't stop us. We continued doing the organizing, having the community meetings to explain, once we developed what the 10-1 plan was about, how it could affect the governance of our city, which I think has been good for the city and for the country. So I think that, it's the case here in San Antonio and in Houston were the model voting rights cases. For the whole country. So a lot can be said about each and every one that was involved. So I thank you for the time and for your consideration. Thank you.
Graciela Sanchez, followed by Linda Wilson.
Buenas tardes. My name is Graciela Sanchez. I'm also a District 5 resident, and I also grew up here and also went to Linear. Go Bokes. I'm here because a lot of people in the community approached me and approached a lot of folks that are connected to different cultural organizations, nonprofit organizations, and they weren't actually happy with the change. They said, "Who is Andres Sarabia?" And I'd have to say, "I know Andres Sarabia. He was a good man. We don't want to go against Andres," but they just didn't know who he was, and they were angry because here's another name of historic space, a public library that didn't come into existence until 1969. I know a few years ago, we were trying to stop the razing of the original Jetson-looking building over there, and people wanted to raze it just to build other elements of, the Las Palmas Mall. So I think we need to really consider, I don't even know what the title is. Is it, the Las Palmas Library de Andres Sarabia? Is it Andres Sarabia's Library de Las Palmas? What is the name? I think people are curious about it, and I don't think we know enough about it. And as other people have mentioned, and including some people who are from COPS Metro who aren't here, but they were saying, but we were all mujeres, that we were doing all this work, and we were, again, raising the monies to make this building a reality. So, in general, a lot of buildings are always named after men, when a lot of women do a lot of the work. And then finally, like Leticia mentioned, the Central Library is the Central Library. It's not named after anybody. he is a big man. He was an important man, not just for the West Side, but for the entire city. So why don't we name the Central Library the Andres Sarabia Library and go bigger?
Linda Wilson, and Ms. Wilson is the last person signed up to speak. If anybody else has not signed up but would like to speak, please sign up and we will add you to the list.
I was late. Can you distribute that to the board? And the reason this is a poem. Oh, I guess I can take this off, right? Can y'all hear me fine, everybody? I know it was hard for me to hear in the back, but I have a big Irish fishmonger's voice. When Andy died, I wrote a poem. I was part of the beginning of COPS. And I'm just going to read this poem. I was asked if I would like to present it here. It was presented at his funeral, because I think it does kind of show what he stood for. Andy Sarabia, a standout man. Andy stood up. When doing so was risky and unprecedented, telling the stories of flooded streets, burst water mains, schools closed, neighborhoods that lacked parks, libraries, and living wage jobs. He stood up, and soon he was not alone, as they stood up. A gente without great power or wealth, calling themselves communities organized for public service, and finally just COPS Metro. They stood together, and I'm gonna just postscript, I did too, although I was in a little bit different neighborhood. They stood together, joining wills in long invincible rows of confrontation, challenging politicians, power brokers, development gobblers, and those who said, we know what's best for San Antonio. They stood united, a raucous crowd in City Hall, school board rooms, bank buildings, and corporate headquarters, rejecting, no, impossible, not in the budget, and that discussion-ending retort, already decided. Until finally, they stood with Andy in victory, watching streetlights, stop signs, parks, and libraries bloom while drainage pipes, bus lines, and school buses forged new paths to homes and neighborhoods. They stood and watched, satisfied, as dollars, millions of them, moved west and south and east and north into neighborhoods so long neglected. At last, Andy could stand down, take a well-deserved rest, survey the changes, yet still he stood strong in forums, rallies, legislative galleries, until God called and said, stand with me, and look at all we've done. And I'm just gonna leave that. I mean, I think that the library should be named for him, with Las Palmas considered too. And maybe this poem can be placed somewhere and other people can be encouraged to write poetry about what they feel and what they think.
That is all the in-person to speak.
Okay, so now we're going to have the written things that we've received. Okay, now we're going to have the written things that we've received, and Jessica's going to read those for us, for y'all, for all of us. Okay. Excuse me, it's been suggested we have a 10-minute break, if anybody needs to... How many?
Two.
Mm-hmm. Two? A 2-minute break. I'm sorry. Okay.
Thank you. All right, we're ready to restart the meeting, so if you could please take your seats, please. We're ready to restart the meeting. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Will you please retake your seat so we can continue the meeting?
Lost half of y'all more. If you have any friends that you can get to come back, please have them do that. So we're going to read the letters and then have voicemail messages that we've gotten. And Jessica's going to start reading those. Okay. Yes. It's on. Yeah, it's on. It's on. It's on. Okay. Okay.
I'm sorry we did that.
The first is from Laura Solis. Let this letter be on record to all members of the committee board, all districts, and patrons that support this cause. I include with each person on this statement that they're grave, that gave their permission to support this letter, with their names and address. My name is Laura Solis, Edgewood resident for 70 years. It is very important to conserve, preserve, and protect the history of Las Palmas Branch Library. Las Palmas Library is a big part of our heritage. Please take a stand and do not change or add to the name Las Palmas Library. I offer my sincere condolences, not just to Andres Sarabia, but to every single patron, including my parents, along with hundreds of caring patrons who have passed away. So many supporters gave their time and support to our Las Palmas Library. These important patrons who are now lost but not forgotten became the original Los Padrinos organization, COPS, and several neighborhood community donations. These hardworking organizations and patrons raised money to purchase many library books, computers, materials needed for our new Las Palmas Library. I am my parents' voice. They will never support to give recognition to just Andres D. Sarabia, who is just one person. It would be a slap on their face and disrespect to all those caring supporters that are not recognized. My suggestion is to offer anyone the fair chance to purchase personalized bricks to be placed in the entrance of Las Palmas Library, or a memorial plaque to be placed on the sidewalks or wall, and use the funds towards the updated needed materials to keep our Las Palmas Library up to date for our future generation. Remembrance of our loyal supporters and everyone who did their part in supporting our Las Palmas Library, past, present, and future. No one stands alone. We are all united. We are a generation. We strongly do not support any changes. Leave the name Las Palmas Library. Sincerely, in closing with a blessing, Laura Solis, Irene Rubio, Gilbert Rubio, Evelyn Rubio, Teresa Rubio, Santos R. Martinez, Gladio Solis, April Sandoval, Jonathan Solis, Matthew Solis, Gloria Camacho, Richard Camacho, Rosa Linda Lugo, Mark Riojas, Janice Cruz Velasco, Renee Gonzalez, April De Leon. The next is from Delia Trimble. SAPL Board. I am not attending the public meeting out of concern for my husband's health, so I appreciate the information on the live streaming link for Saturday. Regarding the name of the Las Palmas Library, by adding Mr. Sarabia's name, I've considered several points. The LP Library celebrated its 50th anniversary in 2019, and Mr. Sarabia's name never came up in relation to the Las Palmas Library in any historical perspective and or presentations. The Communities Organized for Public Service COPS name did come up in the history on mysample.org Las Palmas Library website, but there was no mention of Mr. Sarabia. There has been no information about why Mr. Sarabia and no one else was nominated for the naming honor. Significantly, the Hispanic Heroes mural in the Las Palmas Library features Al Benavides, a respected COPS leader, Cesar Chavez, Henry B. Gonzalez, Emma Teneuca, and Flaco Jimenez. It is my understanding that the mural will be moved permanently to the main hallway during the upcoming 4 month or so renovation starting in late 2021, There will be more permanent, where it will be more permanent and viewed by more people. The mural's center figure is Henry B. Gonzalez. And if any name were to be added to the Las Palmas libraries, it should be reasonably be his because of his documented achievements for the entire city of San Antonio. I haven't heard of a good enough reason for changing the Las Palmas Library's name to include Mr. Sarabia's, so I vote to leave the Las Palmas Library's name as it is, unchanged. She goes on to note, although I am part of the Friends of the Las Palmas Library, I am not speaking for the group. Our members have been asked to submit their own comments. Delia Ramirez Trimble. Eric Estrada, president of Los Jardines Neighborhood Association. Regarding the proposal to consider adding the name of Andres D. Sarabia to the official name of the Las Palmas Branch Library. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board and Naming Committee, I am an interested community person and a member of Los Jardines Neighborhood Association. I wanted to let you know what my opinion on this proposed action is. First, the Las Palmas Library should honor the community that made it possible, not just one person. Second, the San Antonio Public Library Board has not followed the city's public participation directives. There has been very little to no information given, and the community has not participated in a meaningful way, not one day of comments in the decision-making process that is so important for community inclusion and transparency. I do not support the proposed action. Leave the name Las Palmas Library as it is. Hortense Espinosa. Dear San Antonio Library Board and Naming Committee, as a resident of this community for 64 years and a member of the Westwood Square Neighborhood Association, I wanted to let you know what my opinion is on the proposed action on renaming of the Las Palmas Library Branch. The Las Palmas Library Branch is named for the community it serves. To rename a building is erasing the history of why the building was originally named to begin with. After 52 years, why do you want to rename a building? During these current times, there seems to be a standard behavior of renaming buildings. For me, this causes confusion and loss of historical value. Therefore, I do not support the proposed action. Please leave the name Las Palmas Library Branch as it is. Thank you, Hortense R. Espinosa. Gloria P. Hernandez. I have been a resident of the Las Palmas area for over 25 years. I have not heard of a connection between Mr. Sarabia and the Las Palmas Library. For decades, the Las Palmas name has identified the Edgewood neighborhood. I believe the name addition will cause confusion and cause much pain to the local residents. The rich history of Las Palmas means a lot to the people. Let us keep our proud history and our dignity. As president of the Las Palmas Neighborhood Association and part of the Westside Neighborhoods Coalition, I do not agree with adding Mr. Sarabia's name or any name to the library. From the Tier 1 Neighborhood Coalition. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board, what we name public spaces, who makes that decision and why, And in the case, most importantly, how a decision to name a space or building is made is important, particularly when a building or institution such as the Las Palmas Library is the center of a community and its history. Much has been made of a systematic detail that the San Antonio Public Library is not renaming the Las Palmas Library as the Andres Las Palmas Library, but rather just adding to it. Anytime a name is altered in any way, it is a formal renaming. Prior to the pandemic, when the subject of adding a name to Las Palmas Library was introduced, community members raised concern on the transparency of the library board's process and access to information. It is important to ensure that the public is aware of the information surrounding a request to add a name to the Las Palmas Library. How was the request initiated? What information was provided to the library board for consideration? What is the policy criteria the library board considers for the request, timeline, and the public engagement on the matter? The process for adding the name to the Las Palmas Library is one in which the community should fully participate and not just give input at two meetings. As community members engage with the library board, they should understand how the feedback they provide on their community library will be used in the library board's process and timeline for next steps. Places have meaning and memory. The public participation for the renaming of Las Palmas Libraries is a process and not just an event. Please ensure the public engagement to rename the Las Palmas Library is transparent, inclusive, and respectful. While the San Antonio Public Library Board does not adhere to the City of San Antonio's process, we hope the Library Board will consider incorporating the City of San Antonio's Public Participation Administrative Directive, AD 10.1, Public Participation and Engagement, adopted by the City Council as its policy to foster meaningful public engagement. AD 10.1 Public Participation and Engagement Directive, and the URL is provided. Please consider postponing the decision to add a name to Las Palmas Library until an opportunity for the community to participate in a process which engenders trust and accountability is completed. Respectfully, Bianca Maldonado, Cynthia Spellman, co-chairs of the Public Participation Committee of the Tier 1 Neighborhood Association Steering of the... Statement from Velma Peña to San Antonio Public Library Board, Los Padrinos. In the 1970s and the 80s, there was a group of women from Our Lady of Good Counsel that were part of the Guadalupana Society, a religious association organized by Mexican-American Catholic women to provide leadership in social concerns and perform works of charity. Working class and poor women have often made up the bulk of membership in Societas Guadalupanas alongside a smaller group of men. The women learned and applied new leadership and organizational skills. Many participated in the grassroots communities organized for public service, COPS. Our Lady of Good Counsel members of the Guadalupanas joined and became members of Los Padrinos de Las Palmas Library and became very active and were very instrumental in helping the new Las Palmas Library become a reality. Los Padrinos were tireless in their work towards the creation of a new library. There was never a dull moment with these women who cooked in the kitchen and would sell food to parishioners after the noon mass. If they weren't cooking, they would do bingos and would sell food and desserts, always selling something to raise money for their library. They would manage the church booths for church festivals. They did it all. I can speak to these stories because some were my family members and family members to my friends. These feisty, dedicated, smart women would not let you leave their presence unless you bought something that they were selling. And believe me, we would buy whatever they were selling. These mothers and abuelitas were very big believers in education, and they knew that reading was something children needed, especially in our West Side community. They were committed to the community, children's access to books. I vividly remember one of the members of Los Padrinos of Las Palmas Library came with her husband to visit my daughter, who was very ill in the hospital. After praying and small talk, she pulled out tickets from her purse and asked us if she wanted us to buy tickets. We were so used to it that we bought them. Selling tickets was always on their mind. A friend whose mother was also a member of Los Padrinos of Las Palmas told me that her mother was in the hospital and the priest of Our Lady of Good Counsel was called to administer last rites. And the patient was listening to the priest as he was talking to her, and two nurses came to the door. The priest paused and the patient asked the nurse to please get her purse. When the nurse got the patient's purse and gave it to her, the patient took tickets out of the purse and wanted to sell them to the nurses. The priest could not believe what he was seeing and hearing. When my friend's mother died, the same priest from Our Lady of Good Counsel said Mass. He told the story to all the participants at her funeral and mentioned that even in her deathbed, she was trying to sell tickets. These are countless of the other stories. The next is from Irma Solis. As an interested community person and a member of the Historic West Resident Association, I am writing to send my opinion on this proposed action. First, the Las Palmas name should honor the community that worked hard to promote the construction of a library in the Las Palmas area. Second, the SAPL board has not followed the city's public participation directives. Therefore, the community has not been given sufficient information and has not been involved in the decision-making process. I do not support the proposed name change and choose to have the Las Palmas Library remain the same. Thank you, Irma Hoffman, Historic Westside Resident Association. Maritza Sarabia. My name is Maritza Sarabia, Andres Sarabia's great-granddaughter. As you know, today this library is named Las Palmas Public Library. Soon it will be named the Andres Sarabia Public Library. It is not a matter of will its name be changed, but simply when it will be changed. The patient persistence of the proletariat will pay off. I'm fairly certain by now you have heard the stories of his patient negotiations that broke down many a councilperson, business leader, even head of a local bank. He was indeed a social justice maverick. He was David battling Goliath, Harry Potter taking on Voldemort, Ezekiel Midiora defeating Muscular, the latter from my favorite anime. Question to all who are listening, would you have done the same, or would you have stood by watching and listening as you are now? You see, his history is very much the same as those books contained on the shelves in this library. It is the story of the underdog overcoming all odds. He strived to help all, especially the youth. A perfect example is this library he helped rebuild in the city's storied west side. Urban youth lifestyle is not often a fairy tale with a happy ending. However, being able to escape the harsh reality of life for a bit by delving deep into the pages of a fictional book helps cope. Better yet, imagine picking up a nonfiction book about a hero who said yes to fighting to help children's reality become enjoyable. Yes to growth, growing our knowledge. Yes to helping this community. Yes to inspiring the minds of his peers. This book I speak of, I like, is called El Codillo de Andy Sarabia. One day you will check it out from the library over on Castroville Road, the Andres Sarabia Public Library. Maritza Sarabia. From the Westside Neighborhood Association Coalition. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board, changing a historic name is complex, and the subject's issue is a responsibility being guided by the San Antonio Public Library Board of Trustees Naming Committee. People who were sure are committed to examining the complexities of the past and how they respectfully relate to the present. The San Antonio Public Library Board is proposing to rename the Las Palmas Library to the Andres Sarabia Las Palmas Library to honor the first COPS president. The board claims they're not renaming the library, but any change to the original name is a renaming. While Mr. Sarabia is worthy of honor, it was the work of Los Padrinos of Las Palmas Library COPS members from Our Lady of Good Counsel Church, mostly women, who were instrumental in raising money and awareness for the library in their tireless work on book sales, raffles, plate sales, in order to donate all the money raised for books and equipment. The West Side has always been about community effort, and it is inappropriate to honor one person instead of the community that works so hard to make the Las Palmas Library a reality. So many people were involved and instrumental in the passage of the 1989 Library/Literacy Center bond issue, which made for the construction of the new Las Palmas Library branch and the Literacy Center possible. We are requesting that with the new renovations of the Las Palmas Library, a wing or a section of the library be dedicated and honor all of the members of Los Padrinos of Las Palmas Library, along with Mr. Andres Sarabia. By honoring one person, the library erases the memory of those who work so diligently and proudly. No one person should be given the credit. Given Mr. Sarabia's history, it's hard to believe he would approve of one person being singled out and the community left behind. Las Palmas Library is the center of our community and its history. Places and their names are important, and how those places are named is critical. We want the name to remain as it is. We need to have a process that includes community in the decision-making process and honoring all of those who work so hard to create our library. Respectfully, the West Side Neighborhood Association Coalition. From Angie Jaramillo. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board and Naming Committee, as a constituent of District 5 and a community member and patron of Las Palmas Library, I would like to inform you that I oppose the name change of the Las Palmas Library. Although you are adding to the existing name, this certainly changes it. The Las Palmas Library was established in 1969 and has served our community since the 1980s. This library's name is historical for our community. I have asked other community members, young and old, about Mr. Andres Sarabia, and no one seems to know who he is or what relation he has to Las Palmas. They have heard of an organization called Los Padrinos of the Las Palmas Library. They have stated to me that the majority of any accomplishments at the Las Palmas Library was done as a community group effort that put their hard work into it, and not just one individual. Another note, what budget does it entail? Funds should be allocated for a community, not for recognition. Again, I do not support the proposed action. Please leave the name Las Palmas Library as our historic community name. This is from Rhonda Davila. First, thank you for allowing the public to voice their opinion. Please keep the name. Why? People know the name, know the library by that name. Moreover, the whole community is known by Las Palmas. There is a street behind the library called Las Palmas and an elementary school called Las Palmas Elementary and Leadership School. Google Maps also identifies the location, and that makes it easier to find the library. Lastly, the library has lovely palm trees in the front, and that too tells people that they are at the Las Palmas Branch Library. Regards, Rhonda Davila. From Manuel Viriel. Hello, my name is Manuel Viriel. After reading and watching the news regarding Andres D. Sarabia, I was taken back to the late 70s and early 80s and remembered how, as a child, I would really enjoy going to the public library where I lived, called Cortez. I came from a blue-collar family, but a large family that did not have the means for luxuries in life, as father worked and mother was a housewife. And in those times, we did not have internet or such things to keep kids open to the world as today. The library was the internet of its time, and I would love to open a book and learn about life and surroundings and any question any child wondered about, and just explore it and let the imagination run. I now know this man did much to fill in that void for many. And if I could thank him, I would. And also by bringing attention to the libraries again, as so many young will not even bother reading a book, as they can just Google anything they want to and fill their minds with half-truths and other people's opinions and ideas. I would really enjoy this, and I would really enjoy this man's name on a building near his upbringing and community, as he did not just help his surrounding neighborhood. He helped get the community and the city staff itself to invest and open many libraries around communities in San Antonio. And by bringing light to the young minds needing a place to congregate and learn instead of just hanging around. You would be doing a great service by bringing a name change to Las Palmas Library to remind people of places to learn and services at libraries available to them. Manuel Viriel. It's from Hiram A. Garcia. The Las Palmas Branch Library has had the name for more than 50 years. Why is it necessary to rename it? Perhaps Mr. Sarabia could be honored by naming a section of the library after him instead. That would be easier, faster, and less costly, and the building would keep its familiar name of Las Palmas Library. Respectfully, Hiram A. Garcia. From Tony Jean Benya. Dear San Antonio Library Board and Naming Committee, as an interested committee person, I wanted to let you know what my opinion on this proposed action is. First, the Las Palmas Library name should honor the community that made it possible, not just one person. Second, the San Antonio Public Library Board has not followed the city's public participation directive. There has been very little to no information given, and the community has not participated in a meaningful way, not just one day of comments, to the decision-making process that is so important for the community. Everyone I have spoken to in the Las Palmas area has had no idea who Andres Sarabia is. It is, this itself speaks volumes. If any individual's name is to be added, it should be someone who has actively supported and taken action to improve the community the library is in. I do not support the proposed action. Leave the name Las Palmas Library as it is. Tony Jean Benya. From Candace Aguirre. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board and Naming Committee, as a member of this community, I wanted to let you know what my opinion on this proposed action. First, the Las Palmas Library is historical, and everyone knows it's the center of our community, and it should not add the name Andres Sarabia because it is changing the name. I remember going to Las Palmas Library with my grandparents when I was little, and it is a memory I'll cherish forever. Changing the name of this library that has been in the Westside community of San Antonio for ages would be a mistake. It was a whole community, and my great-grandmother was a member of Los Padrinos in Las Palmas Library. They made Las Palmas Library possible, and not just one person. I do not support the proposed action. Leave the name Las Palmas Library as it is. Candace Aguirre. From Diane Dusterhoff. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board of Trustees, I write in support of renaming the Las Palmas Library to the Las Palmas / Andres D. Sarabia Library. Andres Andy Sarabia grew up near the present-day Las Palmas Library, and I felt a lifelong connection to the area. As the first president of COPS, formerly Communities Organized for Public Service, Andy worked with many leaders to secure the political will and funding to build 11 new public library branches, with most on San Antonio's west side. Historically, the west side has received far fewer infrastructure resources than any other parts of the city. Andres Sarabia's efforts, along with the work of many COPS leaders, have been pivotal in addressing these inequalities. After moving to San Antonio in the mid-1990s, the first public library reopening ceremony I attended was the reopening of the Las Palmas Library after a renovation project. I recall Andy Sarabia speaking at that program. In 2011, Andy spoke at the Memorial Library's 30th anniversary celebration. I attended that program to hear Andy's presentation. It was at that time when I asked to join the Memorial Amigos and subsequently became the Amigos treasurer and secretary. Later, I also became the treasurer of the Friends of the Forest Hills Library. Were it not for Andy's work, I might not have joined any of the Library Friends group and taken on these leadership positions. For these reasons, I encourage the Board of Trustees to rename the Las Palmas Library to the Las Palmas Library-Andres D. Sarabia Library. Sincerely, Diane Diesterhoff. This is from Vicky and Cecio. The Las Palmas Branch Library has been a landmark in the historic Mexican neighborhoods which surround it. The local community recognizes it by its traditional name since founded 50 years ago as a center for learning and community activities. The name should not be changed unless a significantly prominent person of historic, artistic, or activist stature can be added to this name as a model for this unique community. Also, when a name is changed just for the sake of change, the new name may no longer be recognized by the community as the same historic center, and attendance might decline. Keep the Las Palmas Library that we love. From Jesse Pena. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board and Naming Committee, as a community member and a regular patron of the Las Palmas Library, I would like for the record to inform you that I strongly oppose the name change of the Las Palmas Library. With all due respect to Mr. Andres Sarabia, Las Palmas Library is a historic landmark in our West Side community, and adding his name is changing the name. The library board needs to hear the voices of community that lives here. Everything now is very political, and I hope your vote is not a political vote, because Mr. Sarabia being a political figure that I actually never heard of until now. Also, there are countless of other persons, male and female, in this West Side community that contributed to making this library a reality. And to honor only one man does not seem acceptable. Jesse Pena. This is from the Olivares family. Dear San Antonio Public Library Board and Naming Committee, as an interested community person and member of Los Jardines, I wanted to let you know what my opinion on this proposed action is. First, the Las Palmas Library name should honor the community that made it possible, not just one person. Second, the San Antonio Public Library Board has not followed the city's public participation directives. There has been very little to no information given, and the community has not participated in a meaningful way, not one day of comments, in the decision-making process that is so important for community inclusion and transparency. I do not support the proposed action. Leave the name Las Palmas Library as it is. Olivares family. From Rachel Delgado, I'm against changing the name of the Las Palmas Public Library. It is named after the neighborhood and should continue to identify it. I suggest Mr. Sarabia be honored with a plaque or naming in the meeting room for him. Perhaps this should be addressed in future remodeling plans. Rachel Delgado. That is all the public comments received by the start of today's meeting.
Good job.
We'll do that next.
About how many do we have?
Three.
Okay.
We also have three voicemail messages that we're going to listen to now.
Okay.
This is Margaret T. Day, D-A-Y.
And we are leaving her telephone number out.
I am very upset that they are renaming the Las Palmas Library for Andres Sarabia. When I was, here I am 75 years old, and I am still upset. This entity, Andres Sarabia, molested me twice when I was 12 years old. But back in the old days, they used to sweep it under the floor, under the rug, you know. They kept everything private, you know, so the public wouldn't know. And then he abandoned my sister, who was his wife. You know, he abandoned her with the two children to live with a young woman who was my age. And he did not marry her until like the year before he died. So, and when he was dying, I spoke to, you know, somebody, a retired priest, and he told me that that was his request. And when he died, he was dying, he asked that the public library be named after him. I said, how horrible. Instead of asking God to take you to heaven, you wanting the library named after you, when this man had such a dark past, abandoning my sister with two children, you know, and her struggling financially and having to go back to work, and he molested me twice. I wish that I had called the police, but my parents didn't allow it. It was my father who grabbed the rifle, and my mother took the rifle away from him. But nothing was ever done, and I'm very upset. He does not deserve to have a library named after him when people don't know about his dark past. Again, you can reach me at the number I just gave you. Thank you. Bye.
Yes, my name is Richard Garcia, Richard D. Garcia. Address is 166 Tesla Drive, here in the city, 7828. President of the Memorial Heights Neighborhood Association and member of the Westside Neighborhood Association's Coalition. Anyway, I wanted just to bring something up to the attention of the board members and also to the library director, Mr. Salazar. I am adamantly opposed to changing the name of the Las Palmas Public Library. Was located on Castroville Road. I see there's something going around there. For some time now, they want to change the name to Andres D. Sarabia. And I said, who is Andres D. Sarabia? I have no idea. We have no idea who this person is. We're here in the community members. We have no idea it is. Why are they trying to change the name of the library? Where is the public comment for residents to voice their concerns about this name being changed? And who brought up this name being changed? Yeah, there's absolutely no reason why would you change the name of the Las Palmas Public Library. Leave it as it is. There's no reason. If it's not broken, why fix it? There's absolutely no reason, and I'm adamantly opposed to this, and I support community members that are adamantly against it. So please, as a constituent, as a registered voter, as a concerned citizen, I would urge you to please leave the name by itself. Okay, do not change the Las Palmas Library. There's no reason. Then what's going to be next? What other name changes are they going to be looking at? Anyway, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. My cell number here is 210-8.
I would like to vote for Mr. Sarabia for the library so he can be selected. I'm Gloria Perez. And I would like to vote for him so he could be selected on the library. Thank you.
And that's all the public comment.
Okay. Okay. Is there anyone else who has not yet spoken but would like to sign up to speak? Okay. Thank you to everyone who took time to be part of this public process. Your feedback, opinions, and comments are valued. There will be no action taken today, but the next step for this committee will be to deliberate and make a recommendation to the San Antonio Public Library Board of Trustees. We also will accept letters and emails and voicemails until we have that meeting and decide. So there's a little time left for public input. The Library Board of Trustees will make the final decision in a public meeting regarding this naming request. And the agendas for our meetings are posted on the city's website. This meeting has been recorded and the video will be made available on the library's website, mysapl.org, as soon as it's available to be uploaded. The time is now 4:05 p.m. and the meeting of the naming committee is adjourned. Y'all have a good afternoon.
Thank you.
I'll turn it off. Okay.